Before we go on, I just want to emphasize this fact that 2's complement addition is identical to unsigned mechanically, which means that we can use the same hardware to do both unsigned and 2's complement addition. The mechanics are the same. And so this is actually really nice, and we'll come back to this later on once we start building a CPU in that module. I also want to emphasize here that the notion of both positive and negative overflow also applies for subtraction. So if we do binary subtraction, we would run it mechanically similarly to how we would do addition, except that we would look at whether things are being borrowed in and borrowed out of the sign bit, rather than looking at the carry in and the carry out bit. So I just wanted to also show you a couple examples of this. So here's one example of 2 numbers, and we're just dealing with 2's complement here for the sake of these examples. So here are 2 numbers stored using 2's complement representation. The sign bits are in blue, so that's this column here. So this is 4-bit 2's complement. So this is the number 3, this is the number 2, and then this is their sum. And you can see how we obtain this by going bit by bit and doing the addition. So we had 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, which in binary is 10, so just like in decimal, we would carry the 1. And so now we'd have a 1 sort of going into this column. And so the result here, this bit, is going to be 0. And then we'd have 1 plus 0 plus 0, which gives us 1. And then 0 plus 0 gives us 0. And so you can see that this worked here, and we didn't have any overflow because 2 plus 2 is indeed 5. And if you look at this last column here, we didn't have any carry into that column, nor did we have a carry out of that column. And so what that means is that we didn't have any kind of overflow here. So here's another example. So here we have a negative 3. So this is negative 3 in 2's complement, which you should verify by negating it and making sure that after negating it, you'd get positive 3. So here we're taking negative 3 and we're adding 4. And mechanically, we do the same thing that we just did. So 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 0 is 0, 1 plus 1 is 2, so we're going to carry the 1, 1 plus 1 plus 0 is also 2, carry the 1. And so now we've finished our addition. We still have 1 left over, and so we might be tempted to think that this is a problem, but if you notice here, we had a carry into the sign bit as well as a carry out of the sign bit. And so that means that we did not in fact overflow here. And if we look at the results, we can see that we added negative 3 and 4, and we got 1, which is valid. Here's where we start to run into a problem, though. So here is 5 and 4, so this is again, in 2's complement here, so we're interpreting this as a sign bit. And so when we do this addition, we have 1 plus 0 is 1. We have 0 plus 0 is 0. We have 1 plus 1 is 2, so we carry the 1. And then here, now we just have a 1 in this column, and so that's the answer here. So you'll notice that if we were interpreting this as an unsigned integer, this would be fine, right? Because we'd have 5 plus 4, and this is the binary representation of 9. So if this were an unsigned integer, we would not have had overflow here because we did not have a carry out of the most significant bit. However, because this is 2's complement, we use that different rule to determine whether or not there's overflow. And here we can see that we had a carry into the sign bit, but no carry out of the sign bit. And that's what indicates to us that we had overflow. In this case, we had positive overflow, and we've now wrapped around, and we have 5 plus 4, and now the answer is 7, which is incorrect. And so that's the indication of that, is that we had positive overflow. Another interesting thing here is that we can add a negative number, or we could think about subtracting. So here is 1 plus a negative 2, and you can see here that this answer just becomes negative 1 if we interpret all these numbers as being 2's complement. And so here we have no carry in and no carry out. But we could also do this as a subtraction, right? So we could have 1 minus 2. So this is now a subtraction operation. All the rest of these were addition operations. So we have to think about this slightly differently. So just like we do in decimal, we kind of go digit by digit. So 1 minus 0 is 1. Here we don't have anything to subtract this 1 from, and so we have to borrow, just like we would if we were doing this in decimal. And in fact, we don't have anything to borrow from here or here. So that means we have to borrow into the number. So we would borrow 10 into here, and then we would borrow another, 10 in binary, which is 2, right? So we would borrow 2, borrow 2, borrow 2. So now we have 1s left in all of these columns, and we have 2 here, so that we can now subtract 1 and get 1. Here, now we have the 1 left over from the borrow, minus 1, or minus 0, which is 1. 1 minus 0, which is 1. And so here we have a borrow into the most significant digit, but we also have a borrow out of the most significant digit. So we had a borrow coming in and a borrow coming out. And so if we look at the resulting number, we see that this is actually fine as well, because we have 1 minus 2, and that gives us negative 1. And so what this suggests is something that should hopefully be pretty intuitive, which is that in 2's complement, adding the inverse of a number is equivalent to subtracting the number. Mechanically, it's the same. And so this is actually going to be quite useful later on once we start building a CPU. We're going to take advantage of this fact to get a subtractor circuit basically for free once we have developed an adder circuit.